why democracy? Why democracy is the central issue for DiEM, for the movement you are launching right now? Do you think that democracy is a buzzword that can be used to actually build a popular movement?
Well, it depends on how you conceptualize democracy. In ancient Athens, the great enemies of democracy, people like Plato and Aristotle, were defining democracy correctly as a constitution in which the poor and the powerless govern. So, to your question, can democracy be a rallying call for the masses, for a mass movement? The answer is absolutely, because this was the original definition of democracy. Now, liberal democracy, of course, from the American Constitution onwards, was all about keeping the demos out of democracy, how to have representation and consultation that would keep the working classes and the lower classes feeling that they were being represented but not really in control of political and economic life. Nevertheless, in Europe, with the creation of the European Union, which is based on a cartel of industry initially and then the financial sector, even that liberal democratic model has been sidelined. So there's been a complete disconnect between the nation states where political liberal democracy is exercised and the centers of power where all the important decisions are made, which is a democracy-free zone. This utter lack of democratic process in the realm where all the important decisions are made is creating this separation of people from power. And it is the real reason why Europe is disintegrating. And the reason being that the whole of capitalism, global capitalism, is going through a spasm, through a major crisis since 2008. But Europe, having separated the realm of politics from the real realm of decision-making, unlike the United States, unlike Japan, is feeling this economic crisis in a far worse manner. It is creating much more deflationary, stronger deflationary forces, and the result is the disintegration of Europe.
Then why not think on first on the national level to democratize and after that on the European?
Well, the national level in the European Union has a democratic process. Syriza was elected. What is there to democratize? We have a parliament.
Well, but the democratic mandate wasn't.
The problem is Europe. Because we had a democratic process that determined that we would be the government and this is a program that we would implement. And then Europe trumped it, effectively crashed it. So democracy is crushed by Europe. Once you realize that, there are two possibilities. One is to say, okay, let's get rid of Europe. Let's disintegrate Europe. Let's go back to the nation state. Let's, you know, effectively dissolve the European Union. That's one possibility. The other possibility is let's democratize the European Union. The reason why DiEM is choosing the second, not the first option, is because whatever when one may think about the European Union, and no one can accuse me of being a friend of the way the European Union functions, its disintegration is going to create, and I keep saying this repeatedly, a new version of the 1930s. Its disintegration is going to be the greatest friend of your Mr. Orban, of the Kaczynskis in Poland, of Le Pen in France, of the Alternative for Deutschland in Germany. It is not progressive Democrats that are going to benefit from the centrifugal forces and the deflationary economic circumstances, which will accelerate massively if the European Union disintegrates.
Okay, and I have a question related more to kind of political economy. You, in your speech, you were talking about all these surpluses and savings and as being the kind of the manifestation and the cause of the crisis in Europe. But if you look at the European periphery, be it Southern Europe or be it Eastern Europe, we actually see the lack of capital and the lack of savings and we see debt. Do you see a way out of that?
Yes, through recycling. of deficits and surpluses. It's the only way you can do it.
Yes.
Either we go back into, or go back, go forward in a direction we've never been before, despite what most people think. What nation states that create borders around them and try to be autarkic and effectively become closed economies and closed societies. Or we stay within an open Europe, open to the rest of the world and open between different countries of Europe. And we make sure that we provide Europe with a mechanism which is necessary to keep it open and to keep it sustainable.
Mm-hmm. But recycling doesn't, as I understand it, the recycling of money and capital doesn't actually make Eastern European state, let's say, less dependent on the centers.
We are all dependent upon each other. The notion of independence mm-hmm. in a capitalist economy, especially a European capitalist economy where we have a single market, is just pure fiction. But to make you feel better, Germany is dependent on the periphery, just as much as the periphery is dependent on Germany.
Yeah, that's...
So the question is not whether how to create independence within the European Union. The question is how to create sustainability at the financial, economic, social and environmental levels. Mm-hmm.